हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। स्टैंडर्ड 8 सब्जेक्ट साइंस पार्ट 3 चैप्टर 7 टॉपिक मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 to 5। नाउ लेट अस सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 6, डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स। एज यू कैन सी इन दिस पिक्चर, मेटल्स आर ब्रास, स्टील, मेटल स्लज, ब्रॉन्ज, while non-metals are silicon, antimony, sulfur and many more. Now let us study properties of metals and non-metals in detail. Metals have luster. See the examples: copper, silver, iron and gold. All are having some shine in it. Having shine means having luster. That's why they are called as lustrous. Non-metals do not have luster. Now see, carbon, sulfur, red phosphorus are some examples, but they do not have shine in it. That's why they are non-lustrous. Metals are malleable. Malleability means if you use a hammer, you can break the metal into a fine thin sheet. So all the metals are malleable, means they can be turned into sheets, while non-metals are not malleable. Non-metals cannot be beaten into sheets, means we cannot make sheets after beating a non-metal. Metals are ductile. This means it can be shaped into wires, but non-metals cannot be shaped into wires. In this picture, you can see the examples of a metal made into wires. There are copper wires, aluminium wires and brass wires. Okay, you can also make wires of silver and gold. Metals are good conductor of electricity, means electricity can easily pass through the medium of metal. While in the case of non-metals, non-metals are bad conductor of electricity, means we cannot pass electricity through non-metals. Now see this. Now in the first figure, the bulb is glowing. It is glowing because key is a metal. And in the second picture, the bulb is not glowing. Why? Because wood is a non-metal. That's why metals are good conductor of electricity and non-metals are bad conductor of electricity. In metals, the flow of electricity is good, while in non-metals, the flow of electricity is very poor. Metals allow the flow of heat from one medium to another medium. That's why metals are considered as good conductor of heat also. While in case of non-metals, non-metals are bad conductors of heat and they do not allow heat to pass from one medium to another medium. After studying this diagram, we can say that metals allow the flow of heat. We can conclude saying that non-metals are usually bad conductors of heat and electricity also. Metals have high density. This is why they feel heavy and sink when placed in water. Means metals do not float in water. They can sink in the water. While non-metals have low density. All metals are solid at room temperature except mercury. Mercury is a metal, but it is in liquid state. Rest, all the metals are in solid state. At room temperature, the non-metals are solid or in gaseous state except bromine. Bromine is a non-metal and it is in liquid state. Rest, all the non-metals are either in solid state or in gaseous state. Lastly, the notes, that is question number 6, distinguish between metals and non-metals. First point, metals have luster, non-metals do not have luster. Metals are malleable, non-metals are not malleable. Third point, metals are ductile, non-metals are not ductile. Fourth point, metals are good conductor of heat and electricity. Non-metals are poor conductor of heat and electricity. Metals at room temperature, metals are in solid state except mercury. At room temperature, non-metals are in solid or gaseous state except bromine. Generally, metals have high densities. Generally, non-metals have low densities. Example of metals are brass, copper, steel, gold, silver, etc. And examples of non-metals are carbon, sulfur, red phosphorus, wood, etc. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share, comment and subscribe my YouTube channel Kids Study Fun and Food. Hope you all are enjoying my videos.